Welcome back to the Azure Enablement Show and our series on learning resources. I'm April Edwards, your host for the series. Now we'll continue our tour of resources ready to help you become a better Azure professional. So without further ado, let's head off to our first destination.
Our next stop is at Video Series.
My name is Isaac Levin, Senior Product Marketing Manager in Azure Marketing at Microsoft.
How did the video series help people get started in tech?
So one of a great learning destination for folks getting started in tech is all the sort of video channels that we have on top of YouTube and Channel 9. So there's all sorts of videos that we could take a look at, whether it be Microsoft Azure, Azure Developer, or Visual Studio. Those allow us to get all sorts of granularity as it pertains to video content for different levels of skill.
Why should IT pros go to the video series?
One of the great video series that we have for IT professionals is Azure Tips and Tricks, which gives you very, very small video segments on how to do a lot of amazing things inside of Azure.
How can an IT pro engage with video series like Azure Tips and Tricks?
One of the things that's really, really amazing about Azure Tips and Tricks is that not only do we have all these amazing video segments, but all these videos come with accompanying blogs. So in the situation where you feel more comfortable reading versus viewing, you have that capability as well. Since one of the great things about Azure Tips and Tricks is that they're so small and they're so, I guess you could call them snackable, is you have the ability to watch multiple of them in a given day. So you have the ability to, hey, I need to look at this particular tip. Oh, there's related tips as well that might help me down the road.
How can the video series help IT pros to succeed?
I want all of our IT pros across the technology to be 100% aware of some of the videos that we offer, including Azure Tips and Tricks. And the reason why is because it's going to help not just you right now, but you in the future.
Coming up, we go to Microsoft OpenHack.
Hi, I'm Tristan Gorange, and I'm a program manager within commercial software engineering, looking after the OpenHack program for Microsoft.
When someone goes to OpenHacks for the first time, what do they find there and how do they get started?
Microsoft OpenHack is a hands-on, challenge-based, deeply technical upskilling experience where development teams progress through increasingly difficult challenges based on real-world customer scenarios designed to mimic the development journey. When teams join an OpenHack, they're typically comprised of 5 participants and 1 coach, where they are formed at the very beginning of each OpenHack. Each team will act as its own dev crew, if you will, each one complementing each other's skill sets and experience so that they can complete each challenge based on the success criteria defined, all with the coach guiding them along the way. Teams are assigned a shared login to access the OpenHack classroom, where gated challenges are presented, both with success criteria and additional resources for them to complete each challenge. Each participant will receive their own unique login to access a pre-provisioned set of resources, whether that be in Azure or other related services, so that they can then go complete each one of those challenges or tasks at hand. Teams who successfully complete an OpenHack will ultimately be able to demonstrate their new learnings with all their skills and workloads in their daily environments.
Why should IT pros get involved with OpenHacks?
IT pros and adjacent technical roles should really consider participating in an OpenHack, given it is the premier upskilling experience where you apply existing skills to solve real-world challenges found in your industry today.
How should IT pros get started with OpenHacks?
As an IT professional, to get started, you'll want to first sign up for an OpenHack by visiting openhack.microsoft.com or contact your Microsoft account rep. One thing that will make you feel right at home when participating in OpenHack is by making it a team experience. Invite your fellow IT pros to upskill alongside of you to go through that OpenHack, so then as a team, you can bring that experience back to your organization.
How can IT pros get the most from OpenHacks?
Yeah, as an IT pro, when participating in OpenHack, it's important to come prepared. In advance, we provide you with suggested learning courses and toolings to come better prepared with. Participants who typically do the pre-work really do have an edge and get the most out of the OpenHack experience.
What is one thing that most IT pros may not know about OpenHacks?
One thing most IT pros may not know about OpenHack is that it is a feedback-driven experience. All the content, tools, and resources used during an OpenHack participants like yourself actually have and are encouraged to provide actionable feedback through the open hack environment. We like to say feedback is a gift. Through a direct feedback loop with the engineering team, we provide them your feedback, which helps them improve product offerings and the technical documentation that you ultimately consume.
Our next stop takes us to Microsoft Reactors.
Hi, I'm Emily Hove, and I have the pleasure of running the program management team for the Global Reactor program for Microsoft.
When someone goes to Reactors, how do they get started and what do they find there?
Well, the best way to get started with Reactor is to join our community. We are found on meetup sites all over the world. And once you join our community, you have access to a wide range of events that are developed by developers, and they are curated by developers and IT pros for developers and IT pros. So there's a mix of content, whether you're just a beginner or you're more intermediate or advanced in your career. There's a wide variety of content delivered by Microsoft professionals, by our partners, and by third-party communities.
Why should IT pros get involved with Reactors?
IT professionals should go to Reactors because there's tons of content to help them advance their skill set. We've got lots of content delivered by Microsoft professionals that are IT pros, and we want to share and impart that knowledge to everyone.
How should IT pros get started with Reactors?
It's so easy for an IT pro to get started with a Reactor. All you need to do is go to one of our meetup sites and join our community, and then you have access to a huge calendar of events that has lots of different topics and subject areas that IT pros are interested in.
Are there any tips for IT pros around Reactors?
If there's a particular topic or subject area that an IT pro is interested in, it's definitely located on our website. We have things that are specifically dedicated to DevOps, and so it's so easy for an IT pro to get started and find topics that are very much of interest to them.
What's one thing most IT pros might not know about Reactors?
IT professionals probably don't know that we have a wide variety of content in the Reactors that is developed by IT pros specifically aimed to helping IT pros continue developing their skills.
This stop of the tour, we go to Flagship Events.
Hi there, my name is Ed Donahue, and I am a senior content experience manager, which means that all of the content that you see at some of our events, I help that come to life.
What are Flagship Events? And how do people get started with them?
When someone comes to one of our major events and one of our online events, which used to be our largest in-person events, so things like Microsoft Ignite or Microsoft Build, the very first thing you should do as an attendee is register. This will get you access to some of our really cool attendee tools that you can use throughout the event, and will also allow you to start building your schedule so that you make sure that you don't miss any sessions that you're interested in.
Why should IT pros go to the Flagship Events?
As an IT professional, you should definitely be signing up for some of our Flagship Events like Microsoft Ignite, because we'll be having some of our larger product announcements, big news will be shared, and any further announcements that can really help you in your work right now.
How should IT pros get started with the Flagship Events?
Of course, the very first thing you should do is register. By registering, you get access to all of our attendee tools, like the ability to build your schedule and to start adding things into your digital backpack. When you add things into your digital backpack, which is one of the coolest features that hopefully can make you feel right at home and like you're at an in-person event, you can later download your backpack so that you have all of those sessions and resources at your fingertips to view and consume later.
Is there any content at Flagship Events that IT pros should pay particular attention to?
As an IT pro, I feel like you might get some really great value from some of our Connection Zone sessions. I particularly love our Ask the Expert sessions. They tie really closely to our featured sessions. So if you go to a featured session and you realize that you have some further questions or you want to dig a little bit deeper into some of the topics, you can head to our Ask the Expert sessions and actually ask Microsoft experts more questions about those topics.
How do the Flagship Events fit into the IT pro learning journey?
As an IT pro, we know that you're constantly learning and constantly trying new things. The way Flagship Events can fit into that is that they provide a great way to be inspired and to learn about the latest products and the latest releases that can help you in your day-to-day work. Once you've learned about those, we provide a bunch of resources that you can take with you to continue your learning journey after the event ends.
What is one thing most IT pros might not know about the flagship events?
One thing that I think a lot of attendees, and IT pros included, don't know about our events is that you can have a digital backpack where you put in sessions, speakers, resources that you can download later. After the event, all of our sessions are available on demand. So if you've gone to Microsoft Ignite and you really loved some of our sessions and you want to share them with your colleagues or coworkers, or you even want to go back and rewatch them yourself, you can do that because they're all on demand for you after the event.
I hope you've enjoyed our tour across Azure Learning Resources. If you're looking to engage with any of the resources we visited in this video, please check the text in this video's description. Enjoy your learning and see you next time.